empieza FuturCon 2011 en la ciudad de Sao Paulo. Iniciamos la sesión habitual de entrevistas con la gente del sector. Y el primero que pasa por nuestros asientos es Keith Kaczmak, que es el vicepresidente y gerente general de ventas globales de una empresa que se llama Powerweb. Y con él vamos a estar hablando en inglés, así que si me permiten, hago la transición a ese idioma. Keith, welcome to Telesemana.
Thank you, Pablo. Nice to be here.
So tell us, the first question I usually ask our invitees is, what is Powerweb showcasing here? What is your message in this market? And I don't know if the message that you're trying to convey here, it also applies to the rest of Latin America.
Sure, absolutely. Yeah, Powerweb is a great company. We've been in the industry for 50 plus years, you know, bringing great technology to the wireless industry. And so Powerweb is here demonstrating a number of things. Power amplifiers, all the way through to antennas, all the way through to some of our in-building products. So we've got some great products, and it's very applicable. We're very much focused on the Brazilian, the South American market in terms of what we're doing.
Okay, do the products that you're showcasing here match what you're showcasing in the U.S. and Europe, or we're talking about lower versions, cheaper versions? What's happening?
It's all very similar. I mean, everybody is using their wireless devices, you know, more and more every day. And what we're seeing also, of course, is, you know, the great increase in terms of usage indoors, in stadiums, in, you know, sporting venues just in general, and then also, obviously, the outdoor, you know, systems. They're being fully taxed in terms of the amount of capacity that's needed. So the same products, you know, very, very much, you know, sort of geared towards the marketplace in terms of frequencies and technologies, but absolutely same needs apply to all countries.
Okay, let's talk about antennas, because probably they play a key role in when we're talking about operators and spectrum. We hear all the time the tale that we need more spectrum.
Right.
Either we have more spectrum or we get technologies that are more efficient with the spectrum.
Right.
What is the role of the antennas to make sure that they can maximize their spectrum assets when they launch LTE and the different technologies that are going to demand a lot of spectrum?
Well, one of the great things about some of the technology that Powerweb has brought to the market is we have multi-band antennas. So one antenna that you put up that can provide capabilities across all bands. And what we're showing here also at the show is what we call the pentaband. So five bands that are able to be carried through one antenna structure. So you put that antenna up today, and everything from 700 megahertz all the way through to 2.5 gigahertz.
Regardless of the technology.
Exactly. Yeah. Technology independent. So it's a great antenna that really future-proofs your cell site. So it's a great system.
Well, given the fact that many operators in Latin America, in Europe or the U.S.,
right.
They have a lot of antennas already in place.
Right.
Now suddenly you bring an antenna that would substitute many of those antennas. What is going to be the process? Are they going to be changing the four antennas they have today for one? They're going to be trying to phase out... How is that going to play out?
It's very much operator dependent. The operator can decide what's important to them. You know, do they want to just replace one aspect of their antennas? Is it better to replace all of them? And we also have some interesting technology that's available, which allows you to basically do fiber optic fed up to the antenna. So I can replace all those cables, those antennas, and put just that one antenna, fiber optic fed. I mean, there's a lot of capabilities there in terms of really reducing the overall load on that tower. And it depends on the tower. I mean, if they're on site specifically, if there's a need to make some changes, this is a good time to do it. And you can really make sure you're set for the future.
Now, what about those technologies that we heard in the past, or at least I heard in the past, and perhaps I lost some perspective on those? Antennas that moved on their own, depending on the congestion and the beamforming solutions and the mine, and all these things. Where are we at with all these solutions in terms of deployments? Because sometimes it feels in this industry that we talk about very advanced features,
right,
and then when you go down to the specific markets, especially in Latin America, we don't see those features being implemented. So I don't know where we are at with those new developments.
You know, I guess on one front, you know, we've got the ability, you're right, to do down tilt and those kind of things manually or electronically. So, you know, there's a capability of providing the right kind of tilt on a band-by-band basis within these multi-band antennas. There's also the ability, you're right, I mean, what's really exciting is when you start looking at the next generation technologies, the LTE, the LTE Advanced, you know, the ability to do multi-in, multi-out. So those are great technologies that bring incredible level of capability in terms of what I'm doing with the spectrum, with my capacity. So you're right. I mean, I think the whole idea is, how do you leverage all these capabilities? If you believe that growth is going to continue, which it really is, you know, we've got to be able to put more spectrum, more bands, more technology. Everything has to be applied, you know, to make this happen. One thing that we're really excited about is, I mean, if you really look at where things are going from a capacity point of view, there are some industry analysts that believe that about 80% of the traffic today happens indoors. And so with those kind of levels, you really need to think about sort of, how do I take care of capacity from an inside-out point of view? And Powerweb is very focused on that. One of the technologies that we've brought to market, which we actually have here, is what's referred to as a picocell.
Mm-hmm.
At the CTIA show earlier this year, we won an award for the picocell as being a very innovative product. that we really believe it brings incredible levels of capacity, you know, really be, you know, be able to provide the coverage capacity you need in an indoor and in a small cell world. So lots of different technologies. How do you bring all these tools to the operator? That's really our goal, you know, all the tools. And again, our view is that absolutely South America has its unique characteristics, but you know, our goal is to make sure that we're supporting South America and the rest of the world, you know, to meet their specific needs.
Okay, in terms of the indoor, which obviously, as you said, right, and I agree, most of the traffic takes place when you are indoors.
Right.
Especially in Latin America, if you consider security aspects,
right,
you're not going to be walking through different streets with your iPhone on your ear,
right,
or browsing the internet. But you know, the antennas and picocells and amplifiers are doing the job.
Right.
But then we're seeing another some other analysts or operators saying, okay, we need to offload using other techniques, Wi-Fi or femtocells.
Right.
Are those solutions competing with PowerWave, or PowerWave is also powering those other solutions?
So good point. I mean, so Wi-Fi we think is a great offload technology. It's actually built into our picocell. So I've got the ability to do different technologies, different bands within the picocell, and also Wi-Fi is supported there too. Because you're right, the requirements are just, you know, it's one of how do you get the right network in place, whether that's a Wi-Fi network or your LTE or your existing legacy networks. I mean, all those need to be covered to be able to support the bandwidth needs of a data user.
Okay, let's talk about Latin America.
Okay.
And PowerWave being in Latin America.
Great.
And we hear, obviously, it's sad to say, but we hear that the U.S. is going through a very stormy kind of economic situation.
Right, very true.
Europe is the same. And Latin America, it seems that it's kind of immune to that atmosphere that we're seeing up north. Is it providing any impetus to the company to look at Latin America and see, okay, that's where we need to go?
Absolutely. I mean, we think Latin America obviously has been an important market and will continue to be. And you're right, the market opportunity here keeps, you know, growing significantly. And we're really excited. We just completed 41 plus miles of the Sao Paulo, Brazil rail system here. So five operators now are on that system, and we've got an expansion that's going on right now. So we believe that, you know, South America, Brazil, you know, specifically, you know, very, very important. And We're here, and we're focused with the, you know, key operators to make sure that things happen here.
What percentage of your business is Latin America, would you say, or how much do you expect to be for PowerWave in the next few years?
That's a good question. I don't have the exact numbers, but I think it's one that will continue to grow. I mean, our goal is, you know, how do we grow this market so that it really does represent a very significant portion of PowerWave's overall revenue.
All right. Well, Keith, thank you so much for stopping by.
Rafael, thank you.
Hope you enjoy the show.
I'm very much enjoying it so far.
And I look forward to talking to you perhaps in the U.S. at CTIA or Barcelona next year.
We'll make that happen. Absolutely. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Bye-bye.